you.
Thanks.
Thank you.
commend her to the mercy of God and pray that the promise made to her in baptism will be fulfilled.
Not only to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? As soon as the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the baby in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed is she who has believed, and the Lord fulfilled his promises to her. And Mary said, my soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has been mindful of the humble state of his servant. From now on, all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me. Holy is his name. His mercy extends to those who fear him from generation to generation. He has performed mighty deeds with his arm. He has scattered those who are proud in their inmost thoughts. He has brought down rulers from their thrones, but has lifted up the humble. He has filled the hungry with good things, but has sent the rich away empty. He has helped his servant Israel, remembering to be merciful to Abraham and his descendants forever, just as he promised to our ancestors. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Rita loved Mary, Mother Mary. Of course, she loved Mary too. That's the reason she's the last one. And that's the reason probably it works well. Today is a feast of Our Lady of Lourdes, and we celebrate this feast, and the family has chosen the reading from the day, also for the feast. It fits well with the life of Rita. We are here to celebrate because she lived 100.02 years. That's the time to celebrate. It's not gone more or feel sad because she lived a life to the fullest. And of course, every member in this parish community knew Rita. She used to come for the lavatory mass and sit on the corner. She wouldn't speak much, but few words with a broad smile was enough. And the community knew her quite well. And it's a privilege for all of us to come here and to pay our final respect to Rita. It's a goodbye. I had a chance to meet her just 2-3 days before she died. And to invite her to her house, she was just staring with a blank look. Did not know who am I, where I come from, nobody around. Once the anointing was over, she went back crawling in the fetal position, and she wanted to go after that. She was comfortable to go back from where she came, the same position. And today's gospel, first reading, is all about our going back, where you come from. St. Paul writes to Timothy, he's in the prison. He had everything done. He knew his death is very near. He wants to go home. And before he goes home, he's writing to Timothy, and he says, I'm already being poured out as a libation, and the time of my departure is come. Libation. In a Jewish tradition, every sacrifice is completed with an act of pouring wine and sharing. In a way, once the sacrifice is over, they will share the wine and say cheers, because sacrifice is complete. That final wine is very important. Even that happens in the life of Jesus. When he is on the cross, he was given the fourth cup. Sip that cup, wine, it's vinegar. And then he says, is a libation poured out, and his time of departure is come. So two simple images. One is cup, that is sacrifice, and second is departure. He's using the very relevant, elegant or usage that is common in that at this time. But he says time of departure is come. It means the boat is ready. Ship is about to leave the shore. Once the ship leaves, they do not know when it will return. Most of the time it won't. Or even if it returns after many years. So Paul is saying, my time is come, ship is ready, anchor is removed, and sails are lowered, and they're ready to sail. He says he's ready to sail to the other part of the world. He's a part of God's world. He's ready. And how does he say he's ready? He says, I fought the fight. I kept the faith. I run the race. Here Paul is very careful in choosing the words. He doesn't say he won the race. He says he's completed his race. He's finished. He ran. That's it. Because in this world, he wants to be only faithful to God. He has not come to win anything. He wants to be just faithful. That's the life of every Christian. We have come here to be faithful to God's will. If you look into the life of Rita, that was her life. She wanted to be faithful to God. And faithful in everything she did. From the very childhood till she died, she wanted to be faithful. Her faith was everything for her. And she did not want to offend her God in any ways. And in different ways, she gave this same message, same teaching to her children. As far as when they were young, made them to kneel and say the rosary. Right? They're good parents. That's the reason your people are good people. But that is a faithfulness. It's not about reward or gaining anything. It's to be in the presence of our Master, with God. Then Paul says, I fought the fight. He speaks about the spiritual fight. And Timothy, while he's writing Timothy, constantly tells Timothy that he has to fight the good fight. He has to keep out every type of heresies away. See that people come before God in truth, love, and respect. Just constantly speaks to Timothy and advises him. In a way, if you see Rita fought her fight, she kept her faith. With all struggles, with everything, bringing up these children, many of them. And it wasn't easy in this present world, but she did. And now she can say, now the crown of righteousness is awaiting me. Of course, every believer can have that crown of righteousness, every believer. Because that is our right because of our baptism. In baptism, we have become the children of God. We have died to ourselves and put on Christ. And in our baptism, because we died to ourselves, we become the children of God. And now Rita can say, I was your child, I was part of your life, now grant me my inheritance. And of course, we know the word inheritance. Inheritance is nothing we achieve. It is given as a gift. And Rita can say, I lived for 100 years as your daughter. Grant me my gift. My inheritance, eternal life. And that is her crown of righteousness. And she would say with Paul, I believe in the righteous judge. God is righteous. He's a merciful judge. St. John Paul's, John of the Cross, in his writing, he says, at the end of your time, you will be judged by love. That is the righteous judge. God knows our innermost heart. He sees how we lived our life. And if Rita says, I fought the fight, I ran the race, and I kept the faith, God knows it. And he will grant her eternal life. grant him eternal life. And we want to remind God, she was his daughter at the time, that if something is lacking in her life, then I'll pray to him for that last sacrifice, that she may find eternal peace forever and ever.
Amen.
rejoices in your presence forever. Their voices we pray join with these in one chorus of exalted praise as we acclaim.
Thank you.
Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all, my friends.
Thank you.
before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. It ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day, we shall joyfully greet her again by the love of Christ which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. As a sign of respect for our sister Rita, we let this incense rise to God who has called her to share his glory. Dear friends, may every mark of affection and every gesture of friendship that you give to others be a sign of God.